Hey, what's up everyone? This week we're going to talk about Swift 5.6 and one of its new additions, which is the keyword any. But before we start, friendly reminder that Swift 5.6 is only available in Xcode 13.3 and above. So if you have an older version of Xcode than this one, well, you will need to update to try out this new keyword. And that being said, now let's take a look at the code behind me. In this code, we have a protocol that I have called networking, and the only requirement of this protocol is to implement a method called fetchData, which is going to fetch at a given URL and return the data that was stored at this URL. That kind of protocol is something pretty standard. I'm sure you have something similar in your app. And for instance, you would definitely implement this protocol through the use of something like a URL session. But for this video, we are not going to focus on how to implement this protocol, but rather how to use this protocol. So if we take a look just below, we can see two possible syntaxes to using this protocol. As you can see, I have two functions, the first one and the second one. If we take a look at the code inside the function, we're going to see that it's exactly the same in each instance. First, I create a URL, and then I use an instance of networking to fetch the data at this URL. And finally, I use the result to do whatever makes sense. And as you've probably noticed, the only difference between these two functions lies in their signatures. Because as you can see, in the first and what seems to be the simplest syntax, I am using my protocol networking right here as a type for the argument that is passed to my function. And in the second syntax, which seems a little bit more complicated, I am introducing a generic argument, so a generic type n that is constrained to conform to networking, and I am using this type n as the type of my argument. And the thing here is that if you are new to Swift and you see these two possible syntaxes, there is a good chance that you're going to be intuitively drawn to use the first syntax, which makes total sense because first, that syntax is simpler. As you can see in the first syntax, I don't need to introduce a generic argument. And also because these two syntaxes look so similar that we could very well think at first glance that they will have the exact same effect. But the thing is that it's absolutely not the case. And as it turns out, the first syntax has much worse performance than the second syntax. And to understand why the second syntax performs much better, we need to put ourselves in the shoes of the compiler. When we are using the second syntax, indeed, we have introduced a generic argument, but that generic argument will be filled at compile time, meaning that at compile time, at our call site, the compiler will know what is the actual type that is used as a generic argument. And so with this information, the compiler will be able to optimize our code because the compiler will know exactly what type is the instance of networking here. But on the other hand, when it comes to the first syntax, things are very different. Because here, the only thing the compiler knows is that the argument networking will conform to a protocol networking. And that's it. The compiler doesn't have any clue as to why the actual type of the argument networking will be. And so that means that the compiler will need to generate some extra code so that at runtime, the call to the method fetchData will be dispatched to the correct type. And this extra code will hinder performances because first, it will make the size of our app a little bit bigger, and it will also decrease performances at runtime because that extra code will have to be executed. And so now with all this information in mind, the problem is pretty clear. The problem here is that the syntax that is the most simple and intuitive is also the one with the worst performances. And as you can imagine, this is where the new keyword any comes into play. And here's how you're supposed to use this new keyword. Whenever you want to use a protocol as a type for either an argument or a property or a local variable, you're supposed to add the keyword any in front of the name of the protocol. And the purpose of this keyword is simply to alert the developer to the fact that using the protocol in such a way is going to have an impact on performances. What's important to notice is that as of Swift 5.6, using the keyword any is optional, meaning that if you don't use it, the compiler will not generate any error or warning. But the plan is that in the next versions of Swift, the compiler will start to emit a warning whenever you are using a protocol as a type for an argument without adding the keyword any. And then starting in Swift 6, the compiler will actually generate an error whenever you try to use a protocol in such a way without explicitly adding the keyword any. So as you can see, this new keyword is something of an interesting case, because when we think about it, this new keyword is actually something of a seatbelt, because this new keyword doesn't actually add any new feature to the language, and instead its purpose is to prevent us from unknowingly writing poorly optimized code. And that's all for this video about the new keyword any. If you want to learn more in details about the motivations behind this keyword, I've put in the description a link to the Swift Evolution proposal where this new keyword has been pitched, and I can only recommend that you go check it out. As always, if you have any kind of feedback, feel free to say it in the comments. Thank you for watching the video, and see you next time.